Are sticking to our three core views despite a very sharp sell-off. We're down almost 20% since early July, and despite the OPEC delay decision. Number one, we think that OPEC will likely go ahead with raising production at some point in coming quarters. We still look for 3 months of increases starting in December, because we think that ultimately that is the optimal long-run strategy to preserve cohesion within the group and discipline non-OPEC supply.
They're going to be putting more oil onto a market that is dealing with possibly a recession at some point.
They will continue to remain data dependent, and so additional delays are definitely possible. We don't look for a recession as our base case, or the recession probability for the US economy from Goldman Research is still 20% over the next 12 months. Second view, we stick to our view that Brent will likely trade in the 70 to 85 five range with some near-term tactical upside, because positioning and valuation are depressed. We have lost 400 million barrels of financial demand since early July. That is basically 7 million barrels per day of financial demand that we lost, and valuation is also a little bit on the soft side. That said, looking further out into 2025, and that's our third core conviction, we do think that the risks to a range, 70 to 85 Brent range, are skewed to the downside because of downside risk to demand and because of upside risk to supply.
The market seems to be complacent about the geopolitical risk. Does that come back as a force to the upside for prices after November the 5th? And if it is a Trump presidency, we know what kind of line he's going to take on Iran, and it will be a harsh one, which does involve perhaps the reimposition of sanctions.
So you're right. I think the market is really not pricing in a significant geopolitical risk premium at the moment. Why is that? I think because the focus is very much on downside risk to demand. Second, we have not seen sustained and large disruptions in the Middle East or Russia for most of the last year, with the recent exception of Libya. And then third, I think the market is increasingly recognizing that you have a lot of spare capacity, and OPEC, in most geopolitical disruption scenarios, would be able to offset the tightening effects, at least over time, of any tightening. But in the short term, one reason we look for a deficit both in September and also early October is the extension of OPEC cuts, but also the Libya disruptions, which we think will keep the market in deficit at least for the very short term. So another reason to look for a slight tactical upside in coming days.